We will do it. We will get to the day where there'll be global celebrations. We get to net zero day, where we brought human CO2 emissions to zero. I think it'll happen in my lifetime. It is doable. But on that day, we have not solved the climate problem. All we've done is stop making it worse.
The problem that remains is heat.
The temperature of the Earth is determined by heat coming in from the sun and heat going out by radiation out to space.
Every single day, CO2 from our past emissions traps energy in the Earth's system. The same amount of energy as 500,000 of the bombs dropped on Hiroshima, detonating at once. That heat is altering our climate.
What's it going to be like when, you know, 3 months of the year are 115 degrees? When vast ecosystems have died out? People are going to push for doing something about this.
And many fear Earth is approaching a tipping point that will trigger rapid change.
The uncertainties that keep me up at night are, what if we aren't doing enough and there's some monster lurking behind the door that all of a sudden comes out into the world among us? It's a good idea that humanity has some sort of a backstop technology, something to do if we get surprised in a way that is very, very dangerous.
Some think that backstop could be solar geoengineering.
It's a way to intercept sunlight coming into the planet to cool the planet.
The core idea is that humans might deliberately alter the Earth's energy balance to compensate for some of the warming and climate changes that come from greenhouse gases.
Geoengineering the climate is a controversial idea. But nature can show us examples of where we might start.